Welcome to Mastering Urban Environments in Blender. Have you ever tried to model an entire city in 3D? Tried to model the dozens of unique buildings that interact with each other properly? Props that fill the streets? Sidewalks, skyscrapers, pipe systems, vast networks of electric wires? Really tried to convey that people live here and they work here and there's culture and that there's purpose. A city that not only looks realistic, but it feels alive. It's an incredibly overwhelming task. And when I first started 3D, I opened up Blender for the first time, really all I wanted to do was create a city. But at the time and still today, it's really hard to find that all-in-one resource that shows you how to create that step by step. And so that is where this course comes in. My name is Cov. I am a 3D artist, and I make things ranging from apocalyptic world environments to creepy abandoned house animations to massive mountain landscapes to ultra detailed hard surface models. And my goal now is to ensure that you guys can finally create that dense, realistic urban environment that we've all been wanting to create for so long. This course covers the creation of pretty much everything that you can think of that goes into a city environment. And by the end of all the chapters, I will have taken you all the way from hatching the very first ideas and story of your world, developing the basics of the city structure from cubes, refining intricate detail, texturing your buildings and objects, to finally rendering out an animation of your complete urban environment. Let me walk you through a closer look at each chapter. In chapter 2, we'll start by planning out our environment. It is really easy to just jump into a 3D scene and start slinging objects around, but gathering references, building ideas, and developing the story behind your project is absolutely crucial. I'll show you how to find references effectively using numerous online databases, and then how to organize them into an all-encompassing guide that we'll refer to throughout the entire project. Chapter 3 is all about how to build a blockout for your city. Now, what exactly is blocking out? You can think of a blockout like the blueprint for your environment. For example, you can't build a skyscraper without a blueprint. You need to know the scale and proportion, general function, and location of objects so that the building doesn't collapse. Similarly, in a 3D environment, before you can start adding detail, you need to establish a blueprint or blockout of the scene so that you can ensure objects are a realistic size relative to each other and that important pieces of your world are in the correct location and form a good composition. And then in chapters 4 through 12, we can jump in and begin to model our city. Now, good news for you, the modeling is actually pretty straightforward and doesn't stray much from a few general techniques. That means you'll quickly become familiar with the modeling process, and you'll be whipping up any building design you want in no time. Throughout the lessons, we're gonna model a large variety of buildings, like this robotic shop, this water management facility, various apartment buildings, the big gnarly gate that divides the city, and even all these massive skyscrapers in the background. You'll be shocked at how simple this actually is, and you'll definitely be confident in building your own city by the end of it. Okay, so now we're moving on to part 2 of the course, starting with chapter 13, and this is all about texturing. Texturing is absolutely my favorite part of any 3D project, and in this course, we'll go into building materials from scratch, developing custom edgeware and dirt systems, creating hand-painted damage, like where paint starts to chip away on the edge of a building and reveal the plaster beneath, reusable materials that we can apply to a variety of different objects, graffiti and stickers, and much, much more, all completely for free inside of Blender. I'll start off by familiarizing you with the basics of texturing, like building materials, mixing materials, where to find materials to download online, and UV unwrapping. Once we are confident with these tools, we'll start systematically knocking the buildings off of our list. Each building is going to receive a ton of care and attention throughout the course, and so there is a special chapter dedicated to each individual one. The thing I love so much about the texturing techniques that we go into during the course is they can be applied to pretty much anything you can think of. Essentially, I will be setting you up with a complete Blender texturing pipeline. Once we have finished up all the texturing, we can move into the third and final part of the course, which is all about arranging our scene and rendering. The scene arrangement chapter is a really exciting and important step to get into, as we are going to basically take our urban environment to the next level by arranging all the pipes, wires, foliage, trees, and props. These are the stages that we can really start to breathe some life into our environment. Any believable city environment needs to be interconnected in order to feel alive. So, what do I mean by interconnected? I mean buildings that are used as homes or workplaces need electricity in order to function. So they'll need intricate systems of pipes and wires to connect to it. This building also needs appliances. So there will be air conditioning units mounted to the side, electricity boxes, antennas, and TV dishes, all of which will also need to be connected together with wires. The building also needs to be able to communicate with other buildings and people. So it has to be hooked up to the main electric grid, which means wires from one building should run to another and then to another. Everything needs to be functional, or at least our jobs as 3D artists is to make it look as though it could function. All of these things together will form a livable, believable urban environment. Finally, in the last chapter, it is all about rendering the city that we worked so hard on. We've modeled all the buildings and objects, we've textured everything, we've arranged our scene with props, and now we need to deliver our project to the world. But before doing so, we need to go over all the technicalities behind a render, basically what are the best render settings for you. We're also going to add atmosphere into our scene using a mist pass, and then we're going to animate a camera to create a cinematic movement through the environment. And finally, once everything is rendered out, we can bring it into the free software DaVinci Resolve to do compositing and color grading. I'm proud to say that I think, despite a city environment being among the most complicated projects to approach in 3D, this course delivers it in a way that beginners will be able to absolutely just jump right in, but at the same time, experienced 3D artists will gain a ton of new skills. Seriously, I'm beyond excited for you guys to get your hands on this course. There's truly so much packed in here, and by the end of it, you will have mastered urban environments. If you would like to join me in this journey, head on over to cgboost.com/urban. And if you purchase within the first month of release, you get this awesome bonus package containing a fully custom and animation-ready robot to help bring more life into your scenes. So, without further ado, let's get into it.